Good evening and welcome to Inside Story. I am Asher Blucher. Inside Story is a weekly magazine program produced by the Agency for Public Information. It highlights government's plans, projects, and policies at work in your community. On this episode of Inside Story, Kingstown Government School students will soon be seated in a transformed facility. St. George's Cathedral makes history in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Music soothes the soul with the band Silk. On Community Beat, we take you to Madeira Heritage Park, the newest eco-friendly park in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. And on Inside Minute, do you know that you can create furniture with locally sourced lumber? Don't go away. Inside Story continues after this break.
For some of us, it's a dream, and for others, it's a calling. But whatever it is that drives you to be innovative, whether you see the need to leave your mark in the sands of time, or you're eager to make tomorrow better for the next generation, whatever drives you to code, bring that to the NTRC iCode 784 competition, where all ideas and mobile app developments are welcomed. Give yourself the chance to win $5,000 in the open category, or a trip to Barcelona, Spain, in the secondary mobile app category to attend an event for startups hosted by the GSMA in March 2021. Your ideas deserve to be heard, and at the NTRC, we're willing to listen. So register on our iCode 784 app between September 8th to September 25th and code the future.
Many schools around the country have opened their doors to a new start. The children of the Kingstown Government School will be more than ecstatic when they walk through the gates. Here is more from Moet Games.
Years ago, 1962, an educational institution began its operation, the Kingstown Government School, commonly called Stony Grounds School. In 2019, a section of the school was relocated to facilitate reconstruction to the school's main building. To date, the reconstruction is nearing an end, and students and teachers may rightfully boast of having one of the best structures. The school's amenities include new installation of washrooms, including for the disabled, bathrooms, library, counselor's office, sickbay, kitchenette, hurricane shutter windows, resurfacing of the yard space, and an entire steel frame roof, making it more safe for a hurricane shelter. A security booth was also constructed with special toilet facility. The construction also saw installation of fire alarms for emergency and smoke detection, as well as washroom facility for principal and deep drains for rushing waters. The reconstruction was carried out by contractor Julius Williams, who said that work should be completed in approximately 10 days. He further said the moving of furniture, cleaning and fittings, and any other minor amendments may take up to 1 month for final completion. The project comes at an estimated cost of $2.9 million, reporting for the API's Eye on Government, I am Mwith Games.
Read, learn, grow, the children are the future, help them. Read, learn, grow, only reading is the key, so help them. Read, learn, grow, let's show them how much fun it is to read, learn, grow, so parents, you play a part. First and foremost, reading from so young is advantageous. Link with the teachers, working hand in hand is a must. Just 10 minutes of your child reading to you is a plus. Get fun books, make reading priority. When children read, they are able to learn. And the more they learn, the more they grow. So parents help your kids read, learn, grow. Reading is fun, kids have to know. Read, learn, grow. The children are the future, help them. Read, learn, grow. So parents, you play a part.
This message is brought to you by the OECS USAID Early Learners Program, funded by United States Agency for International Development. For more information, log on to www.oecs.org/ELP.
St. Vincent and the Grenadines is rich in history. 200 years ago, St. George's Cathedral, that is rich with history, was founded. Inside Story celebrates with the Bishop of the Windward Island and the congregants.
The Cathedral Church of St. George is located on Grenville Street in Kingstown, St. Vincent and the Grenadines. The cathedral is the mother church of the Diocese of the Windward Islands, which is part of the province of the West Indies. On Wednesday, 6 September 1820, the completed Church of St. George, now free from debt, was consecrated to the glory of God. The building is mainly of lava stone in simple Georgian style, standing on some 4 acres of ground. The interior is very striking, with a magnificent Norman arch leading from the nave into the spacious crossing of the transepts. In 1920, when the cathedral celebrated its 100th anniversary of consecration as a parish church, the day was declared a public holiday by the government, and all the dignitaries of the land with thousands of people joined in giving thanks to Almighty God for having established His one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church in their midst, and for the beautiful temple dedicated to this honor. The church serves as servant of the people of God, and as such has always been concerned not only with the spiritual well-being of the people, but also with their physical and mental health. On 6 September 2020, the church celebrated its 200th anniversary with the theme, Affirming Our Heritage, Forging New Paths. The celebration was led by the very Reverend artist Samuel Nichols. Performances were done by the Starlift Steel Orchestra, the Cathedral Choir, and the La Gracia Dance Company.
Thank you.
Reporting for the API, I am Yinka Goodluck.
Don't go away. Inside Story will be back in just a moment.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to our staff meeting. We'll now have the minutes of the last meeting.
Miss Peters, you don't waste bad manners to cough and don't cover your mouth.
Well, listen, I have a common cold, and at some point, it is expected that I'm either going to cough or sneeze. So you all don't have to be that dramatic.
But we don't know if it's cold or COVID.
Some people like be wrong and strong. Imagine you cough and don't cover your mouth, and because people talk is a problem.
Well, no wonder COVID spreading like wildfire across the world.
None of you can give me all the virus in here, you know.
Is either practice good hygiene or I stay at home. I ain't able.
Well, seeing that you know so much about proper hygiene, enlighten me now.
What you mean? It's common knowledge. If you have to cough or sneeze, you cover your mouth with a tissue or the cuff of your elbow so that the virus won't spread in the atmosphere. That's it. It's not rocket science.
Okay, Miss Know-It-All. Now I know better, I will do better.
Remember, it's not about who knows it all. Our health is a shared responsibility. For our next staff development session, I'm going to ask a medical doctor to discuss respiratory hygiene with us. So let's get back to our meeting.
Welcome back to Inside Story. The breadbasket of St. Vincent and the Grenadines has provided a talented group of young musicians whose sound is as smooth as their name, Silk. Inside Story got a listen of the melodious voices. Let's take a listen.
Music is a form of art. It is all around us, on TV, on radio, even on our smartphones. This evening, we bring you the sound of the band Silk.
Yeah, so my name is Brent Williams. I'm a vocalist inside the band, the lead vocalist, musician, songwriter in the band Silk.
And I'm Kivis Pompey, lead vocalist.
I'm Tamara Jackson, lead vocalist.
My name is Lewis, musician.
My name is Raja, bass player and band lead.
Awesome. So the name of the band is Silk. Where did that name come from?
So basically, we were thinking about the nature of the band in terms of the kind of music that we play. How we started off playing was mostly smooth. We played for weddings and others sort of things. And we thought that Silk represented the band well in terms of what we were doing. You know, it was more of a oldie, smooth type of music we were doing. Yeah? I mean, we evolved a bit. No, but that's where we started. So that's where we got the name Silk from, because we thought it represented the band. Well, also represented strength.
Okay, so who's the smoothest member of the band? All right. In everything you do, every experience you have, you persons have influences. Who has been your biggest influence?
Well, individually for me, growing up, I heard a lot of Garnet Silk. And you want to ascribe the same Silk with Garnet Silk and Sanchez. So even Dennis Brown, those were the type of artists I listened to a lot when I was younger.
Well, I could speak for my friends a little bit. Just a little bit. We grew up like with a lot of reggae music and a lot of Motown music. Alright? So in our house we listened to a lot of Bob Marley and a lot of Peter Tosh. But more the old reggae culture and those guys, Money Wailer, back then we used to call us of that. And then we have the Motown artists like Patti LaBelle and Gladys Knight and Percy Sledge and Otis Redding, and that's what our parents really listened to. And so that influenced the kind of music that we kind of started out doing and enjoying. Right?
You guys keep mentioning each other. So for persons who don't know, what's the relation? You said our house, and he said he may speak for me. So,
all right, so let me clarify that. When I say our house, I don't mean the house of Silk. Brent there is my brother, so we grew up together. And we kind of get influenced from the same kind of music a lot. You know, people have their personality and their own personal preference. Alright, so after a while we got into other things like gospel and country and those kind of things. But that's what I mean.
I just want to add though that for me, my main influence came from my father. Because he said, well, he plays the guitar, he's a musician also. And I remember like younger. I mean, I wasn't paying attention to the names of artists and so on and all of those things, but because of him always playing and singing, like every night, I would get up and I would be there with him like throughout the night. So I learned most of the songs from him singing them and not really knowing the artist. So that I would say my father was the greatest influence in terms of the music.
So Brent and Roger are brothers. How did you meet the others?
Sorry, probably long. I guess everybody here basically from the same area, right? And I mean, mostly everybody through church. At the time, it wasn't church, but we had a club, like a boys' club in the community. At that time, we were like really small. I probably was in my early teens, 14, and then we met the others during that. Kivis came along. After Sharam, Brent and Nasa in college, right? But nevertheless, it's from the same area, but the music itself, meeting up as musicians and playing together and singing together, that was after when they were going to the community college, the 11th division, right? But the rest of us were just there.
Who writes? Does anybody in the band write your own music?
Oh yeah, I could speak to Brent and Kivis and Nasa. The whole band writes, well, except for me. I talk.
Okay. What's your writing process? What puts you in the mood to write? Is it something you see or you may hear, a specific sound or life experiences?
Yeah, for me growing up, basically when the rain falls, you know, that triggers my writing skills, if I want to put it down. You know, I wasn't allowed much to go outside, you know, so when the rain falls, it brings about a certain kind of vibes. And, you know, sometimes you just look out on nature and so forth, and it just was just usually flows. Or sometimes you might hear a little rhythm and you just put what you feel towards it. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you just write anything basically as it comes, and then after you tweak it, then it comes into something beautiful.
What's it like being the lone female in the band?
People ask me that all the time. It's good, mostly it's great, but sometimes I get lonely. That's it. But it's like having, we're family, so it's like having four big brothers and they're very protective. So it's good most of the time, but sometimes when it comes to like, you know, want to talk about the girly stuff and things like that, it gets lonely and they don't want to talk about things I want to talk about sometimes. I don't want to listen to the things that the boys talk about sometimes. But other than that, it's great. It's like, you know, we're family, so it's good.
Awesome. So we heard from Brent and Roger that, Brent said his father and the musical background and all of that. How did you get into music?
Oh, well, I didn't grow up in a musical home or anything like that. I just fell in love with it at a very young age and going to church, basically.
Kivis, how about you? Is it the pitter patter?
Growing up, my father loved music. He wasn't much of a singer. I can't remember him singing, but he had a lot of cassette back in that time. And, you know, when his friends and so forth would go to sail and they would come back, they would bring back this, you know, big radio.
Yeah.
You understand? So he had a lot of music, stolen and so on. And my mother's family, on a whole, they loved music. My uncles were guitarists and so on. All of my aunties could sing. So I think they nurtured me at a young age because, you know, back in the church days, you would have what we call harvest, and it's basically a time to show forth your talent. So during that time, you'd get an opportunity to sing, and I think there's where I found my voice, if you want to put it that way.
I heard some stories. I heard that you are the most off-key and you're singing only in the shower. Is that true?
No, that is not true, Inka. It's just that the band is full of so much talent that I just don't want to come out and sing to. It's all lead singers we have, so why? That's why I just play.
Where has been your favorite place to perform?
Oh. Ooh.
I think I could speak for the entire band. It was William Wise in Kanash. Yeah. That was the most memorable. Hands down.
What do you do daily?
All of us?
Yes.
Okay, so start with me. I teach. So I'm a teacher.
You even understand?
Yeah, I teach.
Teacher too.
I'm also a teacher.
I'm a banker.
And another teacher.
Yeah. So we have a band of singers and musicians, and you play instruments, various instruments. Well, I know Brent, he does the guitar and he does the piano as well. Anybody else besides Roger and Aniso play any instruments?
Yeah. I dabble now and again a little bass. Yeah, I love the bass very much, you know. And now I'm going to try another thing with the guitar to find the way.
Unfortunately, I can't play.
Professional tambourine.
Can anybody dance? Who's the dancer of the group?
If you want to say dance, it's not dancing, it's just D.
If you were to give advice to up-and-coming musicians or up-and-coming vocalists or someone who has an interest in music, what would that be?
Well, for me, I would say love what to do. I would say love what to do and never give up, right? Just always keep pressing through. And also a little quote, if something is not working for you, please just change it. Change it, because if you do what you've always done, you will be what you've always been and you will get what you've always got. Understand? So as I say, the definition of a crazy man is doing something over and over, the same thing, and expecting a different result. So if it ain't working for you, change it. Don't stick here doing the same thing over and expect it to work. So that is my advice to you this afternoon.
Even if you don't make it to say like you become a superstar or anything like that, you might have some local success right at home, you know? And you could be the person to influence a whole generation. And so that in itself makes you successful, you know? So I would say be careful with how you measure success.
Anybody teaches music?
I teach the band music, like in this school there's a band, but most of the secondary schools, they have bands, right? So I don't teach in theory, but I do band music, so I have the band and teach them how to sing, how to play the parts and so on. So in that sense, yeah.
So you could say that you've been having a positive impact on your students.
Yeah.
And so I don't teach the music, but like Brent, they're in my school. I teach primary school. So we have a choir, young children. So yeah, I teach them different songs. And you know, they're young children. I teach them songs like that Michael Jackson thing. They don't know about Michael Jackson. I teach them Patti LaBelle, Michael Jackson. I come up to Beyonce, Bob Marley. You know, so I try to you know, influence, put on a little bit of influence on them, get them away from the current thing and take them back. Yeah, because you ask them and they will tell you about the current, but they don't know about, you know, past. So I help them to, you know, look back and see what music was like back then. And funnily enough, they do like it, surprisingly enough. Yeah. Well, it's great to see all of this talent coming out from the valley, as Roger said, because you all are from the same place. Do you think you would ever aspire to have maybe a school just for music, where you can teach how to play instruments, like Gwen said, the theoretical part of it? And is that one of your aspirations?
Yeah, pretty much. Especially in, like you just mentioned, the fact that we're from the valley, from Morocco, and yeah, there in itself would like to see something like that. For me personally, I'd like to see something for that. As Tamara mentioned a while ago, we're kind of drifting in a sense. If you go in the community to search for young people who actually could play an instrument or learn an instrument, it's few, hardly any. And
the few that you have, they are learning it in church. But there is nothing for people who are outside to learn an instrument. The most you might get is the steel pan. I think there was one place in my school that would teach the steel pan. But to teach instrument like the guitar and the piano and even vocals, and so there's nothing for that. Right, so yeah, it would be a really great thing to see something like that start in Mesville and the island as a whole.
Anizo, can you tell us where you see yourself in 5 or 10 years?
I love writing music, right? And different than being a musician, I would say I'm an aspired artist, right? And I want to be, my experiences, I want the world to know of my experiences, because I believe that I will help somebody, and that avenue, that media, is through music, right? So in the next 5 years, I see myself as an artist.
Yeah, to big tune and thing.
Yeah, to big tune and thing, you know what I mean?
In the next 5 years, I want to make sure that Silk is not just a gigging band, but we have our own music, we are known internationally. And outside of that, we would be like the trendsetters. So those people who didn't believe that they could reach a certain point in music, they would look to Silk and say, yeah, we could make it. And by that, a lot of young people start to get involved and so on. So in the next 5 years, I expect that amount of growth from the band and individually.
Well, I think our audience has had enough of hearing me question you and grill you. So we want to hear some of the melodious singing that comes out from the band.
Yeah.
All right? So you guys take it away.
Everybody lies, I'm a fool. They won't get any love from you. Things you won't do from love. Climb the mountain if I have to. Risk my life so I can have you.
Run to rest, let me go.
Dear, it's alive, but I'm still breathing. I don't know what tomorrow may bring, but I've got a feeling. I am alive, must be a reason. I was given one more chance. My heart's still beating. I've been this, I've been that. I've been running against the wind. Faith of mine has with time. After living a life of sin, some never give up, never give in. Termination to win. I survive. Has with time, I survive.
Yeah, so this one is called Quality Time. It's an original track. Soon, you're gonna bite, you know? Well, she's got class.
She's got class.
She's got style.
She's got style.
She's got something in her smile that makes me high. She's my rain on a sunny day. She's the beat to my melody. Darling, it's more than overdue. We need some quality time.
Yes.
Well, hey, Mr. DJ, turn on the music for me and my lady. me sitting up playing on band, my vibes play for the ladies. Squeeze some lovers, rock and set the mood right. Let me rock to the rhythm and at the moonlight. Touch some Vogue and mix it with some Martin. Right, I know me need some loving and me system. I do not touch the vice, just keep it on the same thing. Yeah, she's got class.
She's got class.
Yeah, she's got style.
She's got style.
She's got something in her smile that makes me high. Yeah, she's my rain on a sunny day. And she's the beat. My melody, darling, is more than overdue. We need some quality time.
Easy. It was a pleasure for us being here. The band Silk. You could catch us on Facebook, Silk Music Lovers. You could also catch us on Instagram, Silk Band. Alright? And you could contact us at the telephone number 431-7725. Ask for Roger. The handsome one, yeah. Right,
thank
so
you.
Everybody say bye.
Bye.
Bye. Time.
Welcome back. On Community Beat, we take you to Madeira Heritage Park, the newest eco-retreat in St. Vincent and the Grenadines.
As we applaud the efforts of the Ministry of Health, Wellness and the Environment in managing the spread of COVID-19, we wish to remind you to follow all the protocols. Most importantly, practice proper hand washing, cover your cough and sneeze in the crook of your elbow, do not touch your face, wear a mask when in public or where it is not possible to practice social distancing. Call the COVID-19 hotline at 534-4325 if you're experiencing flu-like symptoms. Together, we can stop the spread of COVID-19. A message by the National Reconciliation Advisory Committee.
Beautiful white and black sand beaches, lush mountains and valleys, rivers, hidden waterfalls, and multiple islands and islets. St. Vincent and the Grenadines. We are a friendly people, welcoming tourists from all over the world with exotic boutique and luxury hotels and a hospitable business environment. Let's make all tourists welcome at our international airport, on cruises, on yachts, on sailboats, on land and sea tours, at beach lines, at our restaurant shops and bars, and at our national festivals. St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Tourism is everyone's business. Live it, love it, embrace
tourism
it.
Tourism is everyone's business. Yeah. Live it, love it, embrace it.
Nestled in the mountains of Bible is the Madeira Valley Forest Park. This rich 5-acre natural reserve is teeming with flora and fauna. There are 5 levels to the park, and even one which represents elements of Ascension heritage. Robert Fitzpatrick tells us how the park got started.
Madeira Valley Forest Park. It started in about 40 years ago, 1980, start planting the trees because we were having problems with drought and people by and large was cutting down the forest to plant bananas, the hide of bananas, and we had long periods of drought. So I decided that I would take out my bananas and plant trees. So I went down to the forestry department and bought a number of trees and plant. But I wasn't aware that there are different types of trees and some are best suited for heavy rainfall area. So finally, Mr. Nichols, Calvin Nichols, who was then the head or chief forest officer, he met me in Kingston and said, Mr. Fitzpatrick, I see you came to the forestry department and bought trees, but those trees you bought, they are not the best trees for your area, They are for heavy rainfall area. So, but you know what? I'll assign a forest ranger to work with you because you're one of the few persons who are planting forest trees. So we did that. He appointed someone, George Beach, to work with me. And then we were planting trees. We get the appropriate trees for the coastal dry area. This is a coastal area. So we plant a lot of cedar and mahogany and so on. More type called West Indian mahogany, which are tolerant to the dry area.
But then you didn't envision that you would turn this area into a park.
Well, somehow I wanted to do that. In the back of my mind, that it would be accessible for people to come through. But foremost was really to mitigate against the dry season. That was the foremost. And afterwards, I decided that I'll do a trail through it and so on and make it accessible for people to come and enjoy themselves.
And now this is 2020, yeah. Almost 40 years after you decided to be planting trees.
Yeah.
What is your vision now for this area?
Okay, the vision for this area is that to make it a place where families come and relax. They could bring their children and enjoy the facility, the grass, go under the trees. In fact, some of the trees we plan to label them. Some of the children who have visited, they see faces on the trees and they get excited about it. And so right now we try to make it as user friendly as possible. As you go along, you'll be able to see what we are doing. We have 5 levels and all the levels are man-made. It was a steep area, and we decided in order to make it user-friendly, we do the trail following the contour line, and also periodically put some flats where people could rest and so on.
And how big is the area?
It will be a total of 5 acres when it's finished.
Okay, 5 acres going up.
5 acres going up and along the river. Of course, it will be a total of 5 acres.
Okay. And I noticed you're doing some construction in front.
Yes.
And you mentioned that there would be a reception area and so forth. Just run us through that.
Okay. So the front, that area, we want it because of trees, agro trees and so on. We want to put at the flat an agro museum. What people used to use in years gone by. Already I have collected a number of pieces, like those old saws that people use to cut in lumber, old jack plane and saw. Because these days, most children would see power saw, electrical saw. But before, it was not electrical saw, it was handheld and hand-used saws. So we have collected a lot of that. Another implement which the younger generation, when they come, they'll be able to see as exhibits. And hopefully they would appreciate from whence we came. Yeah.
When you get fully started, will there be a fee for folks to come in?
Yeah, right now we charge a fee to help to the maintenance. It's not, that's mainly it. We charge $10 per adult and $5 for children over 5. Under 5, we're free with the parents. So that's what it is. So that will help to get some money to help to maintain the park.
So this really is a labor of love for you.
Well, and the communities, there is a group of 20 members. We have a group called Madeira Valley Heritage Park, Inc. Incorporated, and there are 20 members right now. We have a executive committee of 7 members who meet from time to time to discuss where we are going and to make decisions affecting the development of the park. Right, so we are going ahead.
How do you see this park, say, in probably 5 years from now?
Well, if I live that long. But that's one of the reasons why we have a committee. So that they will continue. I hope that this park will continue forever. It would be for the people of the community. And already they're grudgingly getting on board. At first they thought I was crazy to be cutting down bananas to plant trees. Some people even say that we are blocking up the place. They didn't see it. But now they're gradually coming to appreciate and getting involved. So that we had a groundbreaking ceremony when we start that. And a number of the people in the community came forward and others met me and say, well, you didn't tell me that you're having a opening. I say, it's not the opening. It's just a groundbreaking ceremony. When the opening come, everybody would know and everybody would be able to come and visit. So we are getting along.
Yeah. And there's been good response from the community.
Oh, sure. People have been coming from Châtelet, Barry. Well, yesterday we had a group of 6 people. Yes, 4 adults and 2 children. They came all the way from Barley. Some of them came from Barley. I asked them, how they heard about it? They said on Facebook. So it's getting there and so on. So we're interested, very interesting, yes.
Anything else you'd like to add?
Except to say that there are 5 levels, as I said earlier, and we are going to look at each level and we put some platform, not each per se, but there will be platforms as we go along, and we have a platform for the African platform. You would see that when you get go up. We'll have a European platform and an Indo-Asian platform reflecting the people that make up our St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Okay, and we have an area we'll call pre-Columbian platform for the Garifuna and the Caribs and so on. So that on each of those platforms we have heritage, we'll have things that are associated with that epoch. So you have a European platform as well. So that's what it is.
The park is managed by a 7-member executive committee and a 20-member committee of residents of Bayabu. We took the trek up the 5 levels with Fitzpatrick as guide.
The beginning of the trail, okay? And when you decide to get married, you can come here and take your photo. So, please, read the sign.
Use the rope rail. Right.
Thank you.
So you are at level 2. You have 3 more levels to go. At this level here, you have a view to the ocean. You look across. Sometimes if you are fortunate, you can see yachts going up and down, or ocean going liners. So this area gives you a window, it's a window to the sea. This is a bathroom facility. It's operated for the guests. The water is collected from the roof. So it is not pipe-borne water. It is water collected in tanks from the roof. It is, the water is not drinkable. It's used entirely for toilet and for irrigation, wetting the flowers. We're still on level 2. But this is level 2B. we were at level 2A. A. The level 2B, on level 2B, you have a tool room. That's where I keep all my implement tools and equipment. And that is a gazebo.
Under construction.
Under construction. Going on now.
We're level 2C.
Yeah, no, we're going on to level 3.
What is that? This is the same.
Same Marlena Tom. This platform we call mango cluster because they are a cluster of mango trees, and we save these mango trees to attract wildlife, birds and other wildlife there. And but during Easter month, you have a lot of Easter flowers. Come on. These trees will die down before Easter and then they grow up. We call them like resurrection flowers. And they're beautiful in come April. April, May. Beautiful flowers. The whole of this area are flowers. And we have some jasmine as well. So it's a mixture of resurrection flowers and jasmine. So you're going to level.
Oh, the mushrooms.
The level.
Wild mushrooms taste awesome.
It's a forest park, but we do heritage as well. The heritage of our people. So the people of St. Vincent are of African descent, Indian descent, European, and pre-Columbian people, Garifuna and Carib. So this is platform represent the African. So we have two lions on the side of an African sculpture. So for each of the platform representing our people, our culture, we'll have some sculpture. So the first one is this one, how we come from. With the closed eyes, when we came here, the African people came here as slaves. The eyes were closed, they were chained and brought to the West and to St. Vincent. Then you have emancipation and the eyes half open. You have statehood and the eyes open a little wider. And now the African people are governing themselves. So you have wide eyes. So that's a depiction there. So that last one is to show that we are fully in control. Fully in control. That is level five, but it's not developed yet. So we use it as the way out.
The spread of viral infections, including the flu and COVID-19, by practicing proper hand washing. Follow these simple steps. Remove all jewelry before washing hands. Wet hands using running water. Place liquid soap in hand. Circulate using rotational movements, interlace fingers, and repeat switching hands. Wash back of fingers, rotating them in the palms. Wash fingertips, rotating them in palms. Wash thumbs using rotational movements. Thoroughly wash hands down to the wrists. Rinse hands. Dry with clean tissue. Turn off tap using tissue. Use tissue to open door and discard in bin. A simple act can make a huge difference. Stop the spread of viral infections, including the flu and COVID-19, by practicing proper hand washing. This is a message from the Ministry of Health, Wellness, and the Environment.
Stay with us. We learn more about making of local lumber, this on Inside Minute when we return.
St. Vincent and the Grenadines is blessed with lush tropical rainforests. Rainforests are synonymous with pure water, clean air, habitat for plants and animals, prevention of soil erosion, and medicine, among others. Often, we take nature's gifts for granted because they are free and readily available. The chair we sit on used to be a majestic tree somewhere across the world, or right here at home. The Montreal Mountains in Mariaquois has a lush forest cover, with many of the trees planted and managed by the Forestry Division in the Ministry of Agriculture. This area is protected for good reason, and persons cannot cut trees randomly or farm in specific areas. However, if you so desire to create a unique piece of furniture using local lumber, you can purchase a tree to do so. Varieties include Caribbean pine, blue maho, mahogany, to name a few.
Coconut and breadfruit are strong all-time favorites as well. Rainforests play a huge role in keeping our planet healthy. Here's a fun fact. Water generated in rainforests travels around the world. Scientists think that moisture generated in the forests of Africa ends up falling as rain in the Americas. Reporting for Inside Minute, I am Marinese Moses.
Thank you for viewing this week's Inside Story. If you know anyone that is doing positive things in your community that we can feature on this program, please email us at apisvg2014@gmail.com. Let us know who and where they are so that we can check them out. The next community beat might just be coming from your community or near you. Until next week, same time, I am Asher Blucher. Have a good night. Remember, stay positive. Test negative during this COVID-19 pandemic. Good night.